So today we are going to start the very important branch of mathematics, integral calculus. Integral calculus in this level is divided into four parts. First one, indefinite integration. Second one, definite integration. Third one, areas. And fourth one, differential equation. For IIT point of view, once upon a time this part was very important. Every year one problem was used to ask from indefinite integration, but the time when it become objective, very less numbers of problems are coming from indefinite integration. Of course in 2012 one problem came from indefinite integration, but now by the time when it is become objective, density of the problem from indefinite integration are very less. But still, without understanding indefinite integration, you can't do definite integration. And definite integration, I will say for this level, this is the most important chapter. If you will see around last 33 or 34 years IIT JEE question papers, around 80 to 85 problems were asked in last 30 years or 34 years. So you can understand that approximately 3 to 4 problems per year means what I think is minimum of 10 to 15 marks from this chapter only it will be asked, maybe more than that. Next part, these two will come actually under the application of, as you had studied application of derivatives like this, it will come under application of integration. Application of integration, in which of course in this level areas is also important. But what I think is the in these four chapters, this is the most important chapter. Then you will ask me why. Because I will say that these are actually the, this one is another different chapter, but these two are actually the chapters we will discuss only for this chapter. If you will go very next year in engineering first year semester only, you will find that differential equation itself is a subject there. In the maths, a particular unit will be there, differential equation. In this unit, first chapter will be whatever you will study in 12th now. Now what you will study in differential equation, that part will be there, and then with that continuation of, that means second order, higher order will come. So in that way, since in the very next level you are going to study this one, so your basic of this particularly should be perfect. And this will be perfect only when you have the idea of these two chapters. So for this level, I will say most important is definite integral. But for higher education in mathematics, differential equation plays very important role. So these are the four chapters in integral calculus. Today we are going to start with indefinite integration. Indefinite integration. See that you had studied differential calculus. If you had not studied differential calculus, please don't go through integral calculus. I am sure that you will not understand anything. At least from differential calculus, functions and method, a differentiation, you must finish to start indefinite integration. To start indefinite integration, you must know at least functions and differentiation. Okay. Now, indefinite integration. This is nothing but integration is reverse process of differentiation, as subtraction is reverse of addition, division is reverse of multiplication. Like that only I will say that integration is the reverse method of differentiation. Means if suppose a function g of x is there whose derivative is f of x. What? If d by dx of g of x is f of x, then we say that integration of f of x dx is g of x, then you will say that I am saying integration of, and I am writing something like this. Then I will say that as d by dx is a, what is this? Operator. What is this? Operator of differentiation, means when dy by dx given, you will understand the fact that okay, d by dx means derivative. Like that only this symbol dx, this is the symbol of integration, this is actually the symbol of integration, and this dx represents that with respect to which variable you are doing the integration. As we are writing d by dx, this d for derivative and this x for integrate, x for with respect to which particular function you are differentiating, that x is that. Like that only this is the symbol for integration, and this dx, this x means with respect to what you are integrating. Now you know, if you remember in differentiation you studied that derivative means dividing into small parts, limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x by h, dividing into small parts is differentiation. As I tell that the reverse of that means adding all the small parts is nothing but your integration. Adding means summation, na? Summation, see that differentiation, that's why they took this d. Summation means starting from s, now this s only extend up to some x, means extend like this. That's why the string integral symbol is like this. It actually means that summation. Integration is reverse of differentiation, which means summation of all small parts of a function f of x. So what I said here, that if derivative of a function g of x is f of x, then we say that integration of f of x with respect to x is g of x. This is actually the definition of integration. So I will ask you some example. What is d by dx of x square? What you'll say? 2x. What you'll say? 2x. So I will say that integration of 2x is x square. Understand? If derivative of x square is 2x, then integration of right side will be your left hand side. For example, if I will ask you what is d by dx of sine x, what you'll say? Cos x. So if I will ask you what is the integration of right hand side cos x, what you must say? Sine x. But here one more thing I will ask, that what is d by dx of sine x plus 2 suppose? What you will say? Sine x derivative cos x and 2 derivative 0. So derivative of sine x plus 2 is cos x. So what is integral of cos x dx from this one? Again, if I am applying the definition, I am getting here sine x plus 2. If I will ask you what is d by dx of sine x minus 3, what is the derivative of sine x minus 3? Cos x. So from this one, if I will ask you what is the integral of cos x, what you must say? Sine x minus 3. If we observe the definition, if the function derivative of a function is another function, then that another function's integration will be your first function. Is it clear to you? So observe that here also cos x integration, here also cos x integration, here also cos x integration. In these three where I put the tick mark, left hand side is integration of cos x only, but right hand side, of course, one thing is common, every time you are getting sine x, but extra, here that extra was 0, here that extra is 2, here that extra is minus 3, that extra term you are getting. So what I want to say, that if derivative of g of x is f of x, then integral of f of x dx is equal to g of x plus c, we can write, where this c is nothing but called your integrating constant. What is it called? Integrating constant. Now this, because of this c only, the name is indefinite integral. This c can take how many values? 1, 2, 3, 100, 1000, -1, -5, -7, 0, anything it can take. So this c can take infinitely many values. Corresponding to c, different integral values you will get. Did you understand why I kept this c here? See that here 0, 2, -3. So this extra c, because g of x plus c derivative is what? f of x integral will be g of x plus c, where c is your integrating constant. Don't forget to put that c when you will do indefinite integration. Now this indefinite integration, only other name is, you can say indefinite integration. Or, as I told, integration is reverse of differentiation. Reverse means, another word for reverse is anti, anti of derivative, or simply integral, or one more word is there, primitive. Integration or antiderivative or simply integral or primitive have same meaning, means reverse method of differentiation is nothing but your integration. So is it clear to you? So based on this concept only, I will give you some set of formulae. I hope you remember the formulae of differentiation. So one by one I will give you the formula on integration. So first one. Come on, tell me, what is d by dx of x power n plus 1 by n plus 1? What you'll get? N plus 1 into x power n by n plus 1, n plus 1, n plus 1 cancel. What you'll get? X power n. Since d by dx of x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 is x power n, so we can say that integration of x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. Why this c? Because it is indefinite integration. So this is your first formula. What? Integration of x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. Then, come on, tell me, what is d by dx of log x? 1 by x. So reverse. Integration of 1 by x dx, log plus c. Why modding? Because I want that this function should be defined for negative as well as positive numbers also. But log is not defined for negative, that's why we are taking there log mod x. This is your second formula. See that which I am putting in the bracket, these are your formulae which you must remember. First one, integral x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. Second formula, integral of 1 by x dx is equal to log mod x plus c. Third one, come on, tell me, what is d by dx of e power x? It is e power x. So if I will ask you, what is the integral of e power x dx? E power x plus c. Come on, tell me, if I will ask you, what is d by dx of a power x? What is the formula? A power x log a base e. So can I say that d by dx of a power x by log a base e is equal to a power x? This log a base e I am bringing in the left hand side. So derivative of this function is this. So can I say that integration of a power x dx is equal to a power x by log a to the base e plus c? Can I say this is your formula number 4? Write down. See that the numbers which I am writing like this, here I am giving the explanation, that's why I am writing like this, but I want that you must write all these formulas separately in a note, and you have to by heart all those formulae. Okay, very, very important. Come on, tell me, what is d by dx of cos x? Derivative of cos x is minus sin x. Or can I say that derivative of minus cos x is equal to sin x, multiply both sides by negative sign. So derivative of minus cos x is sin x. So what is the integral of sin x? Minus cos x plus c. This is formula number 5. Then come on, tell me, what is the derivative of sin x? What is the derivative of sin x? Cos x. So if I will ask you, what is the integral of cos x? Sin x plus c 5 6. So did you understand something from here, what I am saying? That see, that whatever the integration formula I am giving means integration of this one is this. To understand whether it is correct or not, just take the right hand side and differentiate, you will get the left hand side. And this is the main reason why they are not giving the problems from integration nowadays. What if the 4 options are given, student can easily differentiate the options and he can come to the question. So that is the biggest drawback of this one. That's why mostly the problem based on indefinite integration they are not asking, but still they can create the problems in such a way that whose differentiation will be complicated comparative to integration. So all the chances are there that that one problem may come from this chapter. As 2012 only one problem came directly from indefinite integration. So see that as 6 formulae I had explained you, now I am writing the list of the formulae. And for any formulae, if you just want to confirm that whether it is correct or not, just take right hand side and differentiate the left hand side. So as I told you that write down the list of the formulae from the 1 onwards. So again I am giving you the list of the formulae one by one, each and every formula. First one, integral x power n dx, x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. Second one, integration of e power x dx is equal to e power x plus c. Integration of a power x dx, a power x by log a base e plus c. Integration of 1 by x dx, log mod x plus c. Integration of sin x dx minus cos x plus c. Integration of cos x dx sin x plus c. Integration secant square x dx is tan x plus c. How? Tan x derivative, secant square x. So secant square x integral tan x. Integration of cosecant square x dx minus cot x plus c. Integration of secant x tan x dx is secant x plus c. Integration of cosecant x cot x dx is minus cosecant x plus c. Integration of tan x is equal to log mod secant x plus c or minus log mod cos x plus c. This is the 11th formula. See that the proof. What is the d by dx of log mod secant x? So I hope you had studied differentiation perfectly. I am telling you that if your differentiation is not good, don't try to go through integration. First make differentiation perfect, then come to the integration. Okay. Derivative of log derivative 1 by secant x into secant x derivative secant x tan x. Secant x cancel. Derivative of ln of secant x is tan x. So integration of tan x is ln secant x. Now come on, tell me, ln secant x, can I write ln of cos x power minus 1? That is minus ln cos x, minus ln cos x. So this is the formula for tan x. Integral of cot x dx is equal to log mod sin x plus c. Mostly you'll use this formula only, but another one is there, minus log mod cosecant x plus c. Then integration of secant x dx. I will write better there, little bigger formula. Thirteenth formula, integration of secant x dx log mod secant x plus tan x log or ln e, log to the base e, or you can write ln e also. See that for verification for this one also, dy dx of log mod secant x plus tan x is equal to log derivative 1 by secant x plus tan x into its derivative secant x derivative secant x tan x plus tan x derivative secant square x. That is secant x, if you will take common, what left in the numerator? Secant x plus tan x by secant x plus tan x. Secant x plus tan x, secant x plus tan x cancel. What do you get? Secant x. So derivative of log mod secant x plus tan x is secant x. So integration of secant x will be log mod secant x plus tan x. Cosecant x log mod cosecant x minus, I hope you can verify it. See that the above one, if you understand the explanation for above one, this one easily you can try yourself only. Just differentiate this, you will get cosecant x. Then integration dx by root over of a square minus x square is sin inverse of x by a plus c. We will check how. What is dy dx of sin inverse of x by a plus c? Sin inverse derivative 1 by root over of 1 minus x square by a square into 1 by a. So here what is the LCM? A square. So what you will get here? Root over of a square minus x square, and a square will come out of the root. What will come out? A. That a will go in the numerator. This is 1 by a cancel. What do you get? 1 by a square minus x square. Derivative of this is 1 by root over of a square minus x square. So integral of root over of a square, 1 dx by a square minus x square is sin inverse of x by a plus c. You know that sin inverse x, cos inverse x is derivative is minus of derivative of sin inverse x. So minus will come cos inverse. You can just verify this one, differentiate this, you will definitely get that only. Okay. Verify this one, easy to verify, just take right hand side, differentiate, you will get the left hand. Thank you. we will check this one. Dx by a square. See that till 20th one, as I had done for sine inverse, you can try for these, you will get that one. Okay. Now come here. D by dx of 1 by 2a log mod x minus a by x plus a. Can I write this as 1 by 2a constant outside, d by dx of log of x minus a minus log of x plus a? Log a by b, log a minus log b. So 1 by 2a into this one derivative, log derivative, 1 by x minus a minus 1 by x plus a. 1 by 2a into LCM, x minus a into x plus a, x square minus a square. What will you get in the numerator? X plus a minus x plus a, xx cancel, 2a cancel. What you are getting? 1 by x square minus a square. So derivative of 1 by 2a log mod x minus a by x plus a is 1 by x square minus a square. So integration of dx by x minus a minus x square minus a square, 1 by 2a log mod x square minus a square. This formula is for x square minus a square. Once again check that 1 by 2a log mod x minus a by x plus a, 1 by 2a constant log x minus a minus of log x plus a, log derivative 1 by x minus a minus of 1 by x plus a, x square minus a square, x plus a minus x plus a. Yes, so this is the formula for dx by x square minus a square. What is dx? We are getting what? X square minus a square. So dx by x square minus a square, 1 by 2a log mod x minus a by x plus a. If I will say what is a square minus x square, so observe that, see, from minus came here, so can I multiply both sides by negative sign? So minus of 1 by 2a, so can I write this as 1 by 2a log mod a plus x by a minus x plus c? Just differentiate this one, you will get that. Differentiate this side, you will definitely get this one. Next one. Dx by root over of a square plus x square. See that there it was a square plus x square. Now it is root over of a square plus x square. Your formula is log mod x plus root over of a square plus x square. See that the proof. What is the derivative of log mod x plus root over of a square plus x square? Log derivative 1 by x plus root over of a square plus x square into x derivative 1 plus 1 by 2 root of a square plus x square into 2x. Chain rule 2 cancel, that is 1 by x plus root over of a square plus x square into a square plus x square plus x by root over of a square plus x square. So these two will get cancelled. What will get? Dx by root over of a square plus x square. So derivative of this is 1 by root over of a square plus x square. So integration of dx by root over of a square plus x square is log mod x plus root over of a square plus x square plus c. Similar way you can verify this also. So these are your 27 standard formulae for integration, which at any cost you have to by heart. You don't have any other option. If you will not by heart these formulae, I am telling you very, very clearly that don't try to solve any problem. Because in any problem, you may apply the method, you understood the logic, what you have to do, how to simplify that one. But in every problem, your last step will be the formula. And if you cannot apply the formula, the problem will not be solved. And nowadays, exams are not subjective where you will get the marks for the steps. Nowadays, the exams are objective. So, final answer is the most important thing. How you had solved, how much logic you had applied, how much creativity you had shown, that will not be visible in an objective exam. In objective exam, only thing visible is your final result, final answer, and that final answer completely depend upon these formulae. So at any cost, write down 10 times, 20 times, 100 times, your wish. Unless and until you will not by heart all the formulae, I am telling you very clearly that solving the problem is simply wastage of time. I can give you one simple method to by heart these formulae is just, I think nowadays everybody have some very good mobiles only, at least recording facility will be there. These 27 formulae record in your mobile, and whenever you are traveling from one place to other, or when you are going to sleep, when you used to listen the music, I will say that just record all these formulae, put in your ears when you are going from one place to another place in cycle or just walking or just going to sleep just before 15 or 20 minutes, just put that earphones in your ears and just on that recording. And if you listen again and again these formulae, very easily you can by heart. Out of these 27 formulae, I think, see that from 15 to 27, up to 14, first 14 formulae are very easy to remember also, don't worry, because that is directly reverse of differentiation, easily you can remember. But from 15 to 27, these are little difficult, as I had observed my students, so many students, that they are struggling in particularly 25, 26, 27, means around 15 to 27 in such formulae only, they will struggle a little bit, not much. Mostly they used to struggle from 23 to 27. Up to that, everything you can apply, but I warn that you should not struggle there also. You just first focus on 1 or 2 days of integration. You just focus only on formulae, don't do anything. If you will not do 1 or 2 days any problem, I really don't mind. But 1 or 2 days, if you are not doing any problem of integration, but make sure that from third day onwards, if any formula anybody will ask you at, suppose you are sleeping very in deep sleep, you are there around 2:30 or 3 o'clock, your father or mother came and wake up you and tell me what is root over of a square plus x square. Immediately you are supposed to give the answer. Like that you should by heart these formulae. Then again I am telling you that if you by heart these formulae, integration will be very, very, very easy for you. But if you will not by heart these formulae, it is going to be very difficult. Only those students will say that it is a difficult chapter, those who cannot remember the formulae. If you remember the formulae, this chapter is going to be very easy for you. Actually, from the formula number 21, I have supposed to give this formulae after 1 or 2 classes. But I give this formulae in the beginning only so that when the use will start, this use will come after 2 classes, that how we will apply that one. But I wanted that by the time when this use will come, you should by heart all the formulae. The method which I tell, just try today, okay, just record the formulae, listen 2, 3, 4, 5 times, easily. You don't remember the lyrics, so many songs lyrics you remembered. How very difficult songs lyrics you can remember. So this is very easy, only 27. You can say that it's a song of 27 lines. There the songs are of the 100 lines like that also, isn't it? So it is not very difficult task to by heart all these formulae if you have that zeal to remember them. Okay. Now we will come to the methods. Of course, from 15 to 27 later, when substitution method I will give you, again after some substitution methods, 1 or 2 class, I will again give you the different proof of this one. So far the simplest proof is take right hand side, differentiate and get the left hand side. But later I will give you again a different proof of all these formulae. One more different proof. Only using integration proof is there. That I will give, but little later. Now, integration of f of x plus or minus g of x dx is equal to integral f of x dx plus or minus integral g of x dx means you can simply distribute the integration as we were doing in differentiation also. D by dx of f of x plus or minus g of x is d by dx of f of x plus or minus d by dx of g of x, like that only. Next property is integral k f of x dx is equal to k times of integral f of x dx, means that constant will come out of the integral, constant will come out of integral. These two properties very easy to remember, I think. Just constant, take it out as you are doing in differentiation. Just distribute the integration as you are doing in differentiation also. Okay, now. So far all the standard formula I had given you and these two properties I gave. Now we will do some problems based on this. First one, evaluate integral tan square x dx. See that what I want to say, that these two properties and 27 standard formula, anything from those you can use to solve these problems. So come on, tell me, in tan square x, do you have any standard formula for tan square x? No. But can I write this as integral of secant square x minus 1, secant square x minus 1 tan square x? Can I write that is integration of secant square x dx minus 1 dx? Can I write? Now for this one, I think we have the standard formula, integration of secant square x tan x, because tan x derivative is secant square x. So integration of secant square x tan x minus, now the question arises, what is the integration of 1? Integration of 1 dx, can I write as integration of x power 0 dx? X power 0 is what? 1. Now for x power n, I think we have the formula x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Do you have this formula? But what is x power 0 plus 1? X. That is what you get, x plus c. So what is the integration of 1? X plus c. Remember from now onward that integration of 1 dx is what? X. Many times we will use integration of 1 x. Why? Because derivative of x 1, like that also you can remember, or you can remember like this, that 1 means x power 0. So integration of x power 0, x power 0 plus 1 by 0 plus 1, that is x plus c. So integration of tan square x tan x minus x plus c. Understand? Now see that the problems which I am doing, I want that first you will give an attempt and then see the solution. As you are supposed to try yourself first, what is integration of tan square x before I am solving this one. So whatever the problem I am giving, just note down the question, put a pause mark and then just pause the video, try to solve it. If you are getting it, it's very good thing. If you are not getting, then see the solution what I am doing. But first I want that these some problems you can give an attempt. First you can try it yourself. Second problem is evaluate integral dx by sine square x into cos square x. Come on, try this one first, then I will do. So integration dx by sine square x cos square x. So far any product rule I give? There is nothing like product rule. So far I didn't give any formula. So you can't say that, okay, this is secant square x into cosecant square x. So product rule we will apply and you will get the answer. But so far I had not given you any product rule. So you are not supposed to apply any product rule. Later I will give you that also. But for now we have to think in general to solve this one. So this is, can I write it as sin square x plus cos square x by sin square x cos square x dx? Can I write? How? Sin square x plus cos square x is 1, numerator is 1. Can I write like this? So this I want to write as sin square x by sin square x cos square x plus cos square x by sin square x cos square x dx. So here sin square x cancel, here cos square x cancel, means what you'll get? 1 by cos square x is what? Secant square x dx plus 1 by sin square x is what? Cosecant square x dx. Understand? Cos square, 1 by sine square, sin square, 1 by cos secant square dx plus cosecant square dx, integration I am distributing. So integration of secant square x tan x, integration of cosecant square x minus cot x plus c, write down. Next problem, integral sin power 6x plus cos power 6x by sin square x cos square x dx. So again, one more thing I want to say, that of course as much important your differentiation is there for integration, and as much important to remember the formula of integration, that much important is remembering the formula of trigonometry also. So I hope this is the concept of 12, so I hope you have remembered all the formula of trigonometry. If no, please once again go through trigonometric formula. I am not asking you to solve all the identities, all the problems of trigonometry. I just want you that by heart all the formula of trigonometry. If suppose you didn't remember, I hope you remembered. That is very, very important. You can see that first problem trigonometry, second problem trigonometric identities, third problem trigonometric identities. So trigonometry is useful everywhere, almost in every chapter. So it is always better to remember all the formulae of trigonometry. If directly one or two problems will ask from trigonometry in IIT-JEE exam, but indirectly almost in every problem you have to use trigonometry. So it is always important to remember the formulae of trigonometry. Come on, can I write this as integral of sin square x whole cube plus cos square x whole cube by sin square x into cos square x dx. Sin square x whole cube, sin power 6, cos square x whole cube, cos power 6. So observe that I want to say it is now a cube plus b cube. Do you know the formula of a cube plus b cube? A plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b. Do you know this formula? By sin square x into cos square x. Any problem? Is this step is clear to you? A cube plus b cube, a plus b whole cube minus 3ab into a plus b, but sin square x plus cos square x. 1. Can I take 1 with sin square x into cos square x dx minus, observe, 3 sin square x cos square x by sin square x cos square x dx, because sin square x plus cos square x is 1. So sin square x cos square x, sin square x cos square x cancelled. Any problem? If you observe 1 by sin square x cos square x dx, just now we had done, so can I use directly? But don't do this in the exam. If this problem will come in the exam, means after this you have to solve the previous problem completely. Here why I am using the result, because just in front of me that result is there, but in the exam I don't think you will remember this result. So there you have to again integrate, the complete method you have to apply, okay. So tan x minus cot x minus 3 outside we are taking constant, this is cancelled, so 1 dx, one integral is what? X plus c tan x minus cot x plus minus 3x plus c is the answer. Write down. Next problem. Integral cos x minus cos 2x by 1 minus cos x dx. Next integration. Integral cos x minus cos 2x by 1 minus cos x. I will write this as cos 2x minus cos x by cos x minus 1 dx. Any problem? Taking negative sign common from numerator and denominator and cancelling that. Cos 2x. 2 cos square x minus 1 minus cos x by cos x minus 1. Any problem? Cos 2x formula, 2 cos square x minus 1. As I told, trigonometry formulas are very, very important. Okay. This I will write as 2 cos square x minus cos x minus 1 by cos x minus 1 dx. That is 2 cos square x minus 2 cos x plus cos x minus 1 by cos x minus 1 dx, or 2 cos x into cos x minus 1 plus of cos x minus 1 by cos x minus 1 dx. That is, if you will take cos x minus 1 common, what left inside? 2 cos x plus 1 by cos x minus 1 dx. Cos x minus 1, cos x minus 1 cancel. We can write this as 2 cos x dx plus integral 1 dx. 2 cos x integral is sin x plus 1 integral is x plus, don't forget to write this c. So see that these are 4 formulae. 4 problems which we are just simplifying using trigonometric identities to get an expression which is direct formula. So see that all these are converted into direct formula, and finally we are applying the formula. I am not using any special method, any substitution, nothing I am using. Just formula. If you remember the formula, all these problems easily you can do. Then next method. Methods of integration. Methods of integration, in which first one, substitution method. Substitution method. Substitution method is, suppose you have the integral of the form integral f of g of x into g dash x dx. Suppose this is your I. I am giving the name I for integration. Okay. Suppose integral f of g of x into g dash x dx, then this such type of problems integration you can't do directly. So what you have to do is let g of x is t. What? Let g of x is t. Now differentiate both sides with respect to x. D by dx of g of x is equal to d by dx of t. What is d by dx of g of x? Can we write g dash x is equal to dt by dx, or can we say that g dash x dx is equal to dt. G dash x dx is equal to dt. Then what is the problem? Will become integral of f of g of x is what? T t, and g dash x dx is what? Dt, which you can solve directly. So see that, again I am telling you that whenever, see that this whole, all these steps I explained you how it came, but in now onwards I will directly write this. What if g of x is t, differentiate g dash x dx will be dt. From here onwards, whenever you will do the substitution, directly use that one, that if something is t, its derivative dx will be dt. Problem. Evaluate integral sine of log x by x dx. So what is that inside function? That you should assume as t. So let log x is t. Now differentiate. Log derivative 1 by x dx is dt. See that again I am avoiding all these steps. Directly you can write if g of x is t, g dash x dx dt, because how it came, that explanation I had given you. So this is t, its derivative 1 by x dx will be dt. Come to the problem. If suppose this is your integration I which you have to calculate, then your I will become integration of sine of log x is what? T. And dx by x is what? Dt. And what is the integration of sine t? Minus of cos t plus c, that is minus of cos t. What you had assumed t? Log x plus c. Next one, integral x into sine of 4x square plus 7 dx. You will say again and again why I am giving sine. So okay, this is suppose cos. So let 4x square plus 7 is t. So what is your 8x, 4x square derivative, 8x, 7 derivative, 0 dx is what? Dt, or x dx is dt by 8. Come to the problem. Cos 4x square plus 7 is t, x dx dt by 8, that is 1 by 8. Cos integral sine t plus c, that is 1 by 8 sine of what is t? 4x square plus 7, means your final answer should be in terms of x only. T we are substituting to make the problem easy, but final answer should be your in terms of x only. Write down. Next problem. Integral 3 sine x plus 4 cos x by 4 sin x minus 3 cos x dx. This is the problem. So see that, let 4 sin x minus 3 cos x is t. 4 sin x derivative, cos x minus 3 cos x derivative, minus sin x, so minus of minus plus sin x dx is what? Dt. So problem become three sin x plus 4 cos x dx is what? Dt by t. Integral of dt by t, log mod t plus c, that is log mod t is what? 4 sin x minus 3 cos x plus c. So integration 3 sin x plus 4 cos x by 4 sin x minus 3 cos x is log mod 4 sin x minus 3 cos x. Now when this problem will come like this only, from here I want to give a general result. Observe very carefully. I want to say that integration of f dash x by f of x dx. See that we will derive this formula. Let f of x is t, then f dash x dx is what? Dt. So problem will become integral f dash x dx dt by f of x t. Integral of dt by t is log mod t plus c, that is log mod t is what? F of x plus c. So you can write this as directly log mod of f of x plus c. Remember it as a formula. Integration of f dash x by f of x dx is log mod f of x plus c. See that this function's derivative is this. So f dash x by f of x form. So directly now you can write this as log mod of 4 sine x minus 3 cos x plus c. Write down. One more problem. Evaluate. Evaluate integral e power m tan inverse x by 1 plus x square dx. So suppose this is your I, which you have to find out. So let m tan inverse x is some t. So m into tan inverse x derivative 1 by 1 plus x square dx is what? Dt. Now come on, tell me, what is your I will become? Integration e power m tan inverse x is what? T. And dx by 1 plus x square. Observe that this dt and m will come in the denominator, that is 1 by m. Integral of e power t with respect to t, e power t plus c, that is 1 by m e power t is what? M tan inverse x plus c. This is your answer. Write down. Now see very carefully. Suppose let integration of f of x dx is equal to g of x plus c. What is integration of f of x dx? G of x plus c. I will try to calculate integral of f of ax plus b dx. Means actually it was x, now it become ax plus b. So let ax plus b is t. Differentiate. A dx is what? Dt, or dx is dt by a. So what is your I will become now? Integration of f of ax plus b is t, I, ax plus b is t, dx is dt by a, that is 1 by a. Integral f of x dx was g of x plus c. So integral of f of t dt will be g of t plus c, that is 1 by a into g of, but actually what is your t? Ax plus b plus c. I hope you understand this one, that if integral f of x dx is equal to g of x plus c, final result, if integral f of x dx is equal to g of x plus c, then integral of f of ax plus b dx is equal to 1 by a g of ax plus b plus c. Means if x is replaced by some linear function, then that x coefficient will come in the denominator and you have to integrate that. For example, what is integration of sine x? What is the integration of sine x? Minus cos x plus c. So if I will ask you, what is the integration of sine 2x dx? So x coefficient will come in the denominator. Sine derivative is minus cos x. Observe that sine integration is what? Minus cos x. So this one as it is, but whatever that x coefficient is there, that will come in the denominator. Understand? If you remember the same thing you had done in Differentiation also, that x coefficient there it used to come in product. Means if I will ask you what the derivative of sine 2x, you should say 2 cos 2x. So there x coefficient was coming in the product. But now here x coefficient whatever is there, that is coming in the denominator. Then, so if I will ask you what is 2x plus 3 power 4 dx. X power 4 derivative, x power 4 plus 1 by 4 plus 1, but that what is the x coefficient 2, that will come in the denominator, means 1 by 10, 2x plus 3 power 5 plus C answer. Did you understand this? So, the list of formulae which I gave, what is the first formula? X power n. Now if I will ask you what is a plus x plus b power n dx, what should say? Ax plus b power n plus 1 by a into n plus 1 plus c. If I will ask you what is dx by ax plus b, what you should say? Log mod ax plus b plus c into 1 by that x coefficient coming in the denominator. If I will ask what is e power ax plus b dx, e power ax plus b into 1 by a plus c. Integration of, if I will ask you sine of ax plus b dx, 1 by a cos of ax plus b with negative sign plus c. See that I want to say that till first 14 formulae. I want to say that, see that 1, 2, 3, 4 I wrote. Remaining 10 also you write like this. What? X should be replaced by AX plus B and apply the formula. Only thing is same as it is in place of X, AX plus B will come and extra 1 by A, that X coefficient will come in the denominator. Write down and remember this, that X coefficient will come in denominator. Here also just casually, in one or two problems you will feel difficulty, after that very casually you can solve all these problems. Okay. Problem, evaluate integral cos 4x into cos 7x dx. See that what I am writing, 1 by 2 into 2 cos 4x cos 7x dx, that is 1 by 2 into 2 cos A cos B, cos A plus B plus cos A minus B dx. I hope you know this formula, cos A plus cos 2 cos A cos B, cos A plus B plus cos A minus B, that is 1 by 2 cos integral sine 11x, but as I told x coefficient will come in the denominator, plus sine 3x, but as I said x coefficient will come in the denominator, plus C. Did you understand how I am applying that particular formula which I gave just now? So this is the problem. So see that I want to stop the class today here only, but because what I want to say that the important and the most important thing is those 27 formulae which you must by heart at any cost today only before going to the next class. Okay. So today I gave you all the formulae, then substitution method which is very 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 important method, and first by heart all the formulae. In the next class I will give you integration by parts, means if the product of two functions is there then how to integrate, and some more methods, some more problems we will discuss in the next class.